Good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fine. So let us start reading your 10th chapter, which is Tintin, the comic hero. So Tintin is a name of a cartoon. You may call it a cartoon or a comic hero. In earlier times, when there was no mobile phones and televisions and these kind of gadgets were not there, so the only source of entertainment was reading the comic books, etc. So in those times, these comic magazines were very famous, and this is one of the famous comic character. So Tintin, the comic hero. A comic is a magazine that tells stories through pictures. Basically, comic, what is comic? Comic is a magazine which tells the stories through pictures, means pictorial representation of everything is given, and along with those pictures, wording is written, means what is said by this person, that is written. So in Punjab also, in newspapers, you might have seen in some of the newspapers, there is a very in when we were of the age 6 to 10, then Mrs. Sheila, Shrimati and Googly, these kind of comics were very famous in Ajit and Jagbani newspaper at that time. So similarly, this was a very famous comic. So a comic strip is a series of drawing that tells a story, especially in a newspaper or weekly. So as they have mentioned also that these kind of comic stories are generally in any kind of newspaper or weekly magazines are there. Children as well as adults enjoy reading comics like the Amar Chitra Gatha, Tintin stories, Superman and others. So there are many kind of comics were there in earlier times, and not only kids, adults also enjoy to read these kind of comics. So in today's chapter we are going to talk about Tintin. So how Tintin originated, who made this comic series, all about Tintin. So let us just start reading. The adventures of Tintin continue to interest and fascinate his fans many decades after the irrepressible comic hero first appeared in print on January 10, 1929. So they are talking about the adventures of Tintin. Adventures means to say courageous efforts or kuch bhi jo bhi excited cheeze wo karta tha, that continue to interest and fascinate means to say excite many of his fans many decades after his irrepressible means to say uncontrollable. So uncontrollable first appearance, firstly he appeared in 1929 on 10th January, and after that he continued to entertain his viewers or his readers. The creation of the Belgian author Hege, whose real name was Georges Phosphore Remy, Tintin is one of the most recognized and best loved fiction characters, and perhaps Belgium's most famous icon. So they are saying that that this was created by the author whose name was Georges Phosphore Remy, and Tintin was one of the most recognized and best loved fictional characters, and perhaps Belgium's most famous icon. So in Belgium, because that was created by an author of Belgium, so in Belgium he was a very famous thing, and all over the world was also he was loved very much. Although essentially a comic strip character, Hege knew the importance of accurate research and took care to place Tintin in real and unbelievable world. So actually, whatever he was writing, whatever the author was going to depicting the stories, somewhat factual stories or the truth-based stories. Whatever he was presenting through this character Tintin, he was actually exploring those kind of things, and then he was making the stories. So Tintin is a real and believable word. So clippings from the magazines, visits to museums, consultations with his experts, all contributed to the successful shaping of his lovable character. So because the writer was doing so much research, he was visiting museums and consulting with experts, and because of those efforts, you can say Tintin become a lovable character. And adolescent with no known family, with this endearing character is a journalist, an adventurer and a detective all rolled into one. So now they're talking about the author who had created this comic character Tintin. So that was an adolescent. Adolescent means to say a person of young age, below 18, we may call that person as, you can say, adolescent. And with no known family, means his family was not very much famous, or he was from a very normal kind of family. This endearing character, endearing means to say delightful and lovable character, is a journalist. By profession, he was a journalist, an adventurer and the detective all rolled into one. So this was, you can say, made a journalist and having adventurer nature and detective type of nature. The round face, faced dotted eyes, reporter has only one distinctive feature, this celebrated coif. Coif means to say a special kind of hair style, as you can see from this central picture. So this is basically the picture of the Tintin. So see, if you look at the central portion of his hair, here are somewhat, you can say, like all boys do, ke wo center mein jo hai, pehle tha trend ke wo center mein wo jo hair the wo thode bade hote the as compared to other sides, and usko wo जल वगैरह लगा के स्ट्रेट करते थे. सो सिमिलर वे जो उसने क्रिएट किया था करेक्टर टिंटन, ही वॉज हैविंग दिस काइंड ऑफ लुक, हैविंग डॉटी आईज. एंड डॉटी आईड मीन्स से आईज विद मिसचीफ, मीन्स शरारती सी थोड़ी सी दिखने में ही, नॉट पीसी. एंड क्वाफ मीन्स अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ हेयर स्टाइल ही वॉज हैविंग. सो देन ऑन द नेक्स्ट पेज, द ब्रूसल्स न्यूज़पेपर ली विंगटम Sickle introduced Tintin in a comic supplement and he hasn't looked back since. So Brussels is a capital of Belgium, as our capital is Delhi. In India, capital is Delhi. So similarly, Brussels is a capital of Belgium, and this is the name of the newspaper given, Lee Wintingming Sickle. So they introduced Tintin comic in this newspaper, and after that they never looked back. Means उन्होंने पीछे मुड़के नहीं देखा. फिर they moved very ahead with this, you can say, comic character. The intrepid, ageless reporter has had an uncanny knack of surfacing at just the right moment in international crisis. Intrepid means to say fearless and brave, and uncanny means to say mysterious or strange in an unbelievable way. And knack means to say a special skill in doing things. So what they have written, the, you can say, brave, ageless reporter has had an, you can say, mysterious or strange a kind of skill of doing things, of surfacing at just the right moment in international crisis, means whenever there is any kind of international crisis, he used to write about those kind of things, the solution of those, along with a sporting cast led by his faithful dog Snowy, Captain Haddock, and the eccentric Professor Calculus. Tintin battles good for nothing of all stripes, spies, drug runners, mad scientists and Latin American guerrillas. Gorillas. So see, now that comic was not alone. Tintin was not alone in that comic. There was one dog, and the name of the dog was Snowy, and there was another person, Captain Haddock, and the eccentric. Eccentric means to say behaving in a strange man, you can say strange way. So there was a Professor Calculus was there in that comic, and Tintin battles good for nothing of all stripes, spies, drug runners. So then, and mad scientists and Latin American guerrillas. Guerrillas means to say soldiers who fight against the government. So he used to write about all these kind of things. The boy reporter's first adventure was Tintin in the land of the Soviets, and he exposed the Soviet propaganda and put the communists in their place. So what they're saying now, their first, you can say, adventure or a first article which was very famous was Tintin in the land of Soviets. So Soviet, you can say, basically Soviet Union consists of Russia, etc. So they used to expose the Soviet propaganda. Propaganda means to say agenda, bad kind of, you can say, whatever they are having plannings, they exposed that, usko duniya ke samne laya through these comics. From this debut, he went on to be present at the Japanese invasion of China in 1930 to get embroiled in an oil crisis in Middle East. So again, debut means to say first formal appearance, and embroiled means to say involved in a difficult situation. So again, after the Soviet Union, you can say expulsion. After that, their first debut, from their first debut, he went on to be present at Japanese invasion of China. कैसे Japanese ने China को वो किया, उनमें घुसपैठ की in 1930s to get embroiled. Embroiled means to say in an oil crisis in the Middle East. कि कैसे वो एक डिफ़िकल्ट सिचुएशन में पड़ गए मिडल ईस्ट में, जो ऑयल क्राइसिस हुआ था. ऑयल क्राइसिस मीन्स टू से दे माइट बी हैविंग एनी काइंड ऑफ यू कैन से स्कार्सिटी ऑफ ऑयल सोर्सेज एक्सेट्रा. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ ऑयल क्राइसिस. बिफोर ट्रैकिंग टू द कैपिटल ऑफ क्राइम शिकागो, ही वॉज इन बेल्जियन कॉन्गो इन अफ्रीका. सो देन ही वॉज राइटिंग अबाउट द capital crime Chicago and also the Belgian Congo in Africa. He even went on a voyage to the moon 15 years before Neil Armstrong landed on the moon aboard Apollo. So through this comic also the writer made the Tintin to visit moon. Voyage means to say a special kind of journey for a special purpose, for the discovery of something basically. So as moon is a, you can say, thing that we all want to discover. So 15 years before Neil Armstrong landed on the, as you know, Neil Armstrong was the first person to land on moon. So usse uske jaane ke 15 saal pehle hi unhone comic mein bhej diya tha, jaise movies mein pehle kuch bhi bana dete hain. So in the similar way unhone bhi comic mein isko 15 years pehle usse मून पे लैंड करा दिया. इट इज़ अ फैमिलियर साइट इन दीज कॉमिक स्ट्राइप्स टू सी टिंटिन ग्रैबिंग हिज कोट टू चेज अनदर एडवेंचर विद हिज ट्रस्टर स्नोई इन टो. इन टो मीन्स टू से फॉलिंग क्लोजली बिहाइंड. सो दे आर सेइंग दैट इट इज़ अ फैमिलियर साइट, कि नॉर्मल सी होती थी उनमें, मतलब कॉमिक्स में ये वाली पिक्चर, तो कि वो अपना कोट उठाते हैं टिंटिन एंड अलॉन्ग विद हिज डॉग स्नोई, दे वेंट ऑन एनी काइंड ऑफ डिस्कवरी और डिटेक्टिवनेस और एडवेंचर. From villainous drug smuggler at the sea to expeditions to North Pole and searching for sunken treasures in Caribbean, Tintin and his gang have escaped the jaws of death many times. So in comic they shows that he goes on many kind of expedition. Expedition is also a kind of journey with special kind of purpose. So doing those kind of researches, many a time Tintin has escaped from the death, narrowly escaped from the death. Ke bal bal jaise hum kehte bal bal bache. So that kind of situation he had faced many a time in his life. Courageous, ingenious, modest and practical, Tintin never hesitate to confront the forces of evil and protect the weak. So as we all know, ke koi bhi Superman, Spider-Man, all these kind of characters are made very courageous and ingenious, means to say clever at inventing, and modest and practical. So same was Tintin, and he can confront any kind of difficult situation or any kind of bad evil, you can say evil force or bad force, and he used to protect the weaker ones, as every superhero or Superman do. So the breathless career of this young journalist with his cowlick hair has taken him all over the world in 23 of his comic adventures. So means cowlick hair means to say hair that stick out from the rest of the hairs. Center mein maine aapko pehle bhi bataya, is picture mein bhi aap dekh sakte ho. So he was having that kind of hairstyle, means in which the central portion of hair was different from the rest of the hair. So the breathless career of this young journalist, breathless career means to say very, you can say speedy career, speedy, you can say famousness of this person with cowlick hair has taken him all around the world in 23 of his comic adventures. Means whatever he has been written by the author, ke 23 uske comic adventures aayi, usme se world ke different different countries mein kya ho raha hai uske through usne represent kiya. Around 23 countries. With his exploits, the dashing reporter conquered the hearts of the readers of comic and generated a legion of Tintin fans. So exploits means to say brave and exciting and interesting acts, and legend means to say a large number of people. So with these kind of exciting and interesting comics stripes, the dashing reporter conquered the hearts of the readers of the comic and generated a legend of Tintin fans. Means itne bade logon ki population jit thi, wo uski fan ban gayi thi. So I think one page is missing. So students, with this your chapter is complete. One page which is missing, on which it is written that after that the writer or the author of this comic died, and after that this, you can say, there would be a end of Tintin comic. After that there would be no Tintin comics. So this was the end of the Tintin. So then on the next page they have given you question answers, so you should try these question answers and try the exercise given on the basis of this. Then comes your vocabulary part. So what is given in the vocabulary part? Affixes. An affix is a letter or group of letters which is added either at the beginning or the end of a word to form a different word with a slightly different meaning. An affix can be prefix or suffix. So what they're talking, affix can, it is a letter or a group of letters which is added at the starting of any word or at the end of any word. If it is started at the starting of any word, if it is added at the starting of any word or the beginning of any word, then it is called your prefix. And if it is added at the end of any word, then it is called a suffix. So see, they have given you the examples of prefix. What is a prefix? A prefix is an element placed at the beginning of the word to slightly change its meaning. Sometimes entirely change its meaning. For example, the legal word is there. And if you put IL before the word legal, it will become illegal, which is exactly opposite of legal. Similarly, comfortable. Uncomfortable, you can put the word un before comfortable. So similarly, they have given you here examples like existence, non-existence, president, ex-president, elect, re-elect, legal, illegal, patient, impatient. So all these words are having anti-meaning. So most of these are having anti-meaning, like ill, im are having anti-meaning, re means to say again. So like this, they are having you can say, when they are added to the word before any word, they change the meaning of that word. Legal means to say, which is something which is permissible by the government, or you can say, jisko hum kanuni bol dete hain. And illegal means to say kya, kanuni. So opposite of that. Patient means to say the person who is having patience to bear something, and impatient is exactly opposite of patient. So like this, we can add these prefixes to change the meaning of that particular word, and then we can use that word. Then comes your suffix. A suffix is an element placed at the end of the word to form another word, like nation, national, belonging to that nation, national. Or suffocate, suffocation. So the words like T-I-U-N-A-L, these kind of words are usually added at the end of the words, and these are called your suffix. So now they have given you more prefixes, like study how new words are formed from related words, like unfinished is the opposite of furnished, formed by adding the prefix un, then irrespectable, irrepressible, interpret, then embroidered, so like this. Then prefixes like en, em, over, these can be used to form different words like enable, empower, overcome, like this. So then there is exercise B1. Pick the words that contain affixes, cross the ones that don't have. So what you have to do here, just you have to check which word is having affix attached to it. Affix can be now a prefix also or suffix also. You have to check the beginning of the word also, and at the same time you have to check the ending of the word also. There may be a word or 2-3 letters given in the starting that are your prefixes, or the words like T-I-O-N-A-L, these kind of words may be present at the end of the word, which are called your suffix. So first, what is important? Basically, you want to you have to find the root word. Leaving those prefixes and suffixes, you have to find the root word here. So important word, if you remove the word im from here, important has no meaning. So you can do like this. So important has no meaning. This word is complete word important. We have not added im to the important to make important, and then it has a different meaning from important. No, it is actually basically a root word. Important word is a word and in which im is not an affix. So this you have to cross. Then impartial. So here im is added to the word partial. Partial means to say where there is a bias, any kind of bias, kisi ek taraf jhuka hona, that is called partial. Or half ko bhi partial bol dete hain. So impartial is opposite of partial. So im word here is attached before the word partial. So it's your prefix. So yes, the affix is attached. So you have to tick this word impartial. Then lengthen. So again, length plus en. So lengthen is, you can say again, en has been added to the word length. Length has a separate meaning, so that's why lengthen is your word which is having a fix. So that's why again you have to take this one. And anti-national, so national, opposite of national is anti-national. So yes, anti word is attached before national word. So yes, this is your again a fix. So I am leaving the rest of the words for you. You have to tick and cross according to your judgment that whether this word is having any kind of a fix. A fix means to say either prefix or suffix. So check those words, and later on you will be provided with the answer keys, so you can cross check your answers at that time. So try once these words. Then again in B2, what you have to do, write the opposites of the following words using suitable prefixes from the box. So like words are given like great, kind, sense, unity, legal, social, understand, patient, convenient, religious, and along with that a box is given in which prefixes are given. An, ir, im, ill, de, in, anti, non, dismiss. So like this, these words are given like misunderstand, illegal, antisocial, like this. Many words are there. So you have to check which word, unkind, like this. You have to be, you can say, you have to try this exercise also. So just to try, I have done half of you. For example, degrade, unkind, nonsense, or disunity. So like this, you have to do all these words. Try these also. Then in B3 exercise, so students, in your B3 exercise also, what they have given you, look at the word great. Find the words with the following meanings. Like they have given you hints for the cross and downs, and these words are the antonym formed by adding prefixes. Circle them vertically and horizontally. So what you have to do, see, first one is your non-conforming with accepted standards of behavior, so that is called your indecent. So you have to find indecent from here. Then bad luck. So bad luck, misfortune. Bad luck is misfortune. So you have to find misfortune word here. This is given in the second line. Across second line, it is starting with the miss word. Misfortune is given. Then something that cannot be believed. So that is called your incredible. Incredible, find the incredible word. This is also in across. Incredible. So yes, incredible. Yes, fourth line, it is given in the fourth line, starting from the starting letter INCREDIBLE, incredible. So similarly, you have to check the down ones. Eighth is given, unsocial, sociable speech or behavior. So that is called incalinity. You have to find these spellings. Then not direct means to say indirect. So if you check in the column side, so it is given in indirect. Yes. So students, you can find, yes, in the second row, in the second column you can call. So after N and M, third word is I is given. So indirect is given here. So I hope it is clear to all of you how you have to find. So you can do this now. Then B4 is use the words from the word grid in B3 to fill in the blanks. So yes, what you have to do now, you have to fill the blanks with the words that are formed in the B3 grid. Means whatever you have found in these across and downs, those words you have to fill in the blanks. So again, first of all, you have to solve this B3 grid now. Then you can do this one. So I am leaving it for you. I am not disclosing the answers of these. You have to solve this grid, and then you have to find the words, and those words you have to fill in the given blanks. Suitable words you have to fill in the suitable blanks. So with this, your prefix is over. Then comes your suffix. So what are suffixes? There are many suffixes such as ment, and ly, ending with ly, able, ible, acy, ous, ation is very common, ful, ity, all these are your suffixes. Means these words you will find at the end of the other words, like excitement, saintly, understandable, sensible, supremacy, then victorious, exclamation, beautiful, generosity, attendance, occurrence, all these words. So when a suffix is added, sometimes there is a change in spelling, as in the case of final E and Y. So relate, relation, beauty, beautiful, like this. So B5, what you have to hear? Fictional, you have to split the base, what are the root word from the suffix. As they have given you one example, like fictional. So fiction plus al, then famous, fame plus us. F-A-M-E, fame plus O-U-S, then essentially, essential plus L-Y, essentially, successful, success plus full, then lovable, love plus able, then ageless, age plus less, then faithful, faith plus full. So all these words are there. And you have to do this. I have already done this for you. Then the suffix A-N-C-E is added to form nouns denoting quality, action or state. For example, generally the suffix A-N-C-E is related to the words that end in A-N-T, like observant, observance, then significant, significance. So to make these kind of nouns of quality, action or state, we can use this suffix. Then if the word ends in E and the E is usually dropped, like resemble word is there and you want to form resemblance by adding A and C, so you will drop the last E from the word. Then generally the suffix ens is related to the words that end with the word ENT. So if your word is ending with the word ANT, you will add the suffix ANCE at the end of that word. And if your word is ending with the word ENT, then you will add the suffix ENCE, silent, silence. So in this way you will be able to check the spellings of the words also. You need not to cram the spellings. You can simply check that if the word is ending with ENT and if you want to make silence from silent, so you will not write ANCE, you will write ENCE because it was already ending with ENT. Similarly, violent, again ENT, so it will change to ENCE, violence. Then competent, competence, so like this. Then B6, form new words by adding the suffix ANC or ENC as appropriate. So we have already discussed that where you have to edit ANC and where you have to edit ENC. So if the word is ending with ANTE, you will add simply ANCE. And if the word is ending with ENT, then you will add ENCE. For example, first is resistant, and resistant is ending with ANT. So we will simply write resistance as R-E-S-I-S-T-A-N-C-E. Then ignorant, again ignorant is ending with A-N-T, you will add A-N-C-E. Excellent is ending with E-N-T, you will add E-N-C-E, excellence. So in the similar way, rest of the words you have to do like this. So I hope it is clear up to B6. Then comes grammar portion. So what is given in the grammar portion, students? Active passive voice. So I am going to make an already I have made when you will see this video. So at that time I must have uploaded the video on active passive voice. So you can check that video also. Here I will tell you in brief that what are active passive voice. So see, read the following sentences like the Belgium author Hege created a comic character called Tintin. This is the active form. Or if we say a comic character called Tintin was created by Belgian author Hege, then it is your passive form. So active form is the one, the doer of the action or the subject gets importance. In which subject gets importance, in which the person who is doing the action that gets importance, that is called your active form of sentence. Like in the first one, the Belgium author Hergé created a comic character called Tintin. So we are giving importance to the author, Belgian author. So this is active form. And now in the second, we are giving the importance to the object, like a comic character called Tintin was created by a Belgian author Hergé. So in the similar way, in second example also, the adventures of Tintin fascinate his fans. It's your active form. We are talking about, we are giving pressure upon the adventures of Tintin. And in the second, we are doing the opposite thing of the first. Like, Tintin fans were are fascinated by the adventures. So it's your passive form. So when an active sentence is turned into passive, the object of the active sentence become the subject of the passive sentence. This you have to remember while changing an active to passive. This is the basic rule, that your subject of active become the object of the, you can say, passive, and object of the active sentence become your subject in passive. Basically, what you have to remember here, that your object of the active voice or active sentence become the subject of your passive. Whatever is written at the end of the active, you will have to start your passive sentence with that word. So this is the basic thing. Then in passives, verbs are usually formed using forms of be with the main verb. Like if we are talking about any past sentence, active form mein aapko lag raha hai past tense, then you will use the helping verb was. If you feel that this is having active form is of present form, then you can use SMR depending upon the subject, and so on. So they have given you example, a report was prepared about the poverty in village by the village officer. So active form, what was the active form? The village officer prepared a report about the poverty in the village. So see, from the active form, you can see the village officer prepared a report about the poverty in village. Village officer prepared. Prepared means to say we are talking about past. Second form of the verb is given. So that's why we have used which form of be verb? Was, which is used for past. So a report was prepared about poverty in village by the villager officer. So this is then if you have noticed, we are using a word by, preposition by, in all the passive forms till now. So we often use passive form by when the action is more important than doer. For example, Suman's favorite was broken by RF yesterday. So most of the sentences, and most of your sentences, we will use this preposition by. So in this sentence, the fact that the vase was broken is more important than who broke it. So contrast this with its active form, like RF broke Suman's favorite vase yesterday. So like this. Then the passive is also used for impersonal construction with it, like it is predicted that there will be a heavy downpour in the next 2 days. Downpour means to say heavy rain. So it is said that the flood situation will worsen. So if you look at these sentences, the passive form is also used for impersonal construction with it. So it can be used. Then the passive voice is used when we have to use the passive voice, when the doer is understood, like the thief was arrested. It is understood that he was arrested by the police. So then the mark sheets were distributed to the class by the teacher is understood. So in that case, we can use then when the doer is not known. The documents were stolen, but by whom the documents were stolen, that is not known. Then the lock was broken, but by whom, that is not known. Then you can use then. Third is when the speaker wants to remain neutral by not specifying the doer of the action, like the chairman was bribed to award the contract to PJ Films, but the speaker either doesn't know or doesn't want to say who bribed the chairman. When you don't want to disclose something, then also the journalist was threatened on phone, but the speaker don't say who threatened the journalist, kisne threatened kiya, that was not being told by the person, the speaker. So at that time, you can use this passive voice form. Then fourth is when the doer's identity is to be kept confidential, to kept secret. Confidential means to say which is highly secret. So it is reliably learned that there will be some changes in the team. Okay, pata chala hai ki team mein kuch changes hone wali hain, but that is secret. Okay, what could be the changes? Then we are told that one of the prisoner has escaped. Okay, hame pata chala hai ki prisoners mein se ek koi hai, wo bhaag gaya hai, lekin who, that is again don't know. Then in all impersonal writing, such as scientific reports, formal notices, announcements, news headlines, and so on, strike called off, bill introduced in Lok Sabha, passengers are required to proceed for boarding. So like this in all these sentences also, we use passive form. Then in C1, complete the following paragraph about the origin of the name of the city Bengaluru in Karnataka. Use the correct form of verbs given in the bracket. You may use the active or passive form of the verb. So it's upon you. You can use active form where you think like, okay, here we need active form. And for passive, we have done these 5 rules that in these cases, we have to form a passive sentence. It's better if we form the passive sentence. So what you have to do here, you just have to fill these blanks with the correct form of the verb. And in passive, we always use third form of the verb. And along with that, we have to, we have to use the correct form of verb be. That is, SMR, was, were, and those kind of things. So try these exercise. C1 and C2 also is a similar kind of exercise. Then C3 also, this is all related to your active and passive voice. So students, try these exercise once. And later on, you can match your answers with the answer keys also. And we will discuss these kind of things with your in your Zoom sessions also. So then the table is given. So in this table, you will come to know that which tense will change to which one in the passive form, how you will change the tense. So tense we have already done in your first term. Sorry, I have made the videos, but that was not there in your first term. You can watch those videos now. So 3 videos are there uploaded on our channel. You can say present tense, past tense and future tense. So you can watch those videos to get information about tenses. And then in voice, you just have to check which tense will remain same or which will change. So like this, you have to be careful about this. So then with this, your chapter is complete. Then you can complete your listening section by listening the audio of your this chapter from your app. So with this, your chapter is complete. So I hope you enjoyed this chapter very well. So thanks for listening and have a nice day.